Lots of views, likes, and followers are what most people want as a content creator. The amount of times I've heard, if only I had 1 million subscribers, I'd be able to quit my 9-to-5 and become an influencer. But what if I told you that in order to make money online, it isn't about getting a lot of followers, likes, and views? That magical thing is community. Community is the reason why Emma Chamberlain has a multi-million dollar house, but also could post any type of video and people would still watch. Community is the reason why Taylor Swift could not post any music for the next 3 years, but there's gonna still be Swifties out there supporting her and talking about her. So listen up, because in this video, I'm gonna talk about how these creators and you can build a strong community. Because in order to make money online, you need trust, and that's what community is. So with all these videos on how to make money online, the thing we forget is the way you make money is through an audience that trusts you as a creator. And that is through the community power. So that's what we're gonna talk about today. We're gonna talk about how to build a cult-ass following, okay? First off, I want to say in my last video, I explained the next wave of marketing and creator economy, which is going to be with blockchain and crypto. The thing I have to say about this is we're moving away from creators making money through brand deals and merch, moving into this more high risk, high friction world of ownership, right? Creators making money through selling NFTs, which the audience owns a share of that, right? So when you move into the space of no longer buying something, but owning a piece of something, there's going to be a lot of friction. It's already hard to ask people to buy your merch, let alone ask people to buy your social token, right? Or NFT. So you really need a loyal ass community that's willing to go through that friction with you. And I really do believe the next 3 years, most creators are gonna lose their income because they don't know how to build a community that goes into Web3. If you wanna know more about what Web3 is, I will link that video below. So what is the real definition of community? This is not the official definition, but I like it better than the actual one. It basically says to build a community, you have to care about people and you have to make people feel like they belong. That's what you do as an influencer or a community leader or cult leader in this aspect. The biggest misconception I see is people saying followers equal community. Just because someone follows you doesn't mean that they're a community member, right? AKA, just because you have followers doesn't mean that you care about people and people feel like they belong. Like, it has no relevance, right? There's so many examples of this. There's this girl that has like 3.2 million followers that couldn't sell 10 shirts. There's this whole article around her, and that happened a few years ago, and there's more and more people like that. We call them fake influencers. And the word influencer has so much bad connotation. There's this, literally a video last week from Colin and Samir talking about this. We need a new definition of a creator. We need to be more community leaders versus people with a bunch of followers. We need to care about people and make people feel like they belong, which most people don't give a shit about. Most people care about views, followers, and likes. And I've been there. So how to create a community like Emma Chamberlain, like Taylor Swift, like Gary Vaynerchuk? I broke it down into 3 steps that I've observed, I've used in my company, I've used in my personal community. And the first step is having bold ass values. It's so important that before you even build a community, you know what type of community you want to build. What are the shared values? There's another definition of community that says a group of people with shared values. Emma Chamberlain is a really great example of this. She's very raw to the point where she will say fuck, shit, bitch, anything. And her values are just being authentic to herself. There's another podcast called Call Her Daddy, and their values are becoming a boss ass bitch, becoming independent. And you can see that in Alex Cooper, the founder or cult leader of this community. By the way, if you are in the daddy gang, comment below, because Jade is too. The second thing is you have to care about people. I know this is pretty obvious, but you'd be surprised how many people forget this, AKA me. For longest time, I only cared about how this YouTube video would make money for me. I didn't care about people because I was just so blindsided to monetizing. I used to not be this way. I used to make videos with no end result. I used to make content that literally was just free. So we need to be able to do something without a financial return. Like I said, Emma Chamberlain is a really great example of this because she doesn't make videos that are maybe the most profitable in keywords, right? She's just making vlogs about anything she gives a damn about. And that is because she cares about her community over getting more AdSense or money. Of course, she's a fucking rich ass shit, but she wasn't able to get there if she didn't give a shit about the money. Third thing is making people feel like they belong. Once you share your values, you show people you care, you're consistent with making a bunch of content, I think making people feel like they belong comes with an identity. For example, Taylor Swift fans are named the Swifties. Gary Vaynerchuk fans are named Vayner Nation. People that are fans of me, you guys are called Dharma Nation. I think if you're able to identify what community looks like with a name, some sort of like leadership, people feel like they belong because they can see that if I want to join this club name, I have to have these values. And therefore, I feel like I'm a part of something, if there's like a name around it. I literally, like, honestly, hold up. It's the reason why I have Call Her Daddy merch. All right, so a little business update. I have X8 Media, which is my Web2 agency, and I also have my second company called Create. It's a Web3 incubator. I mentioned last week that I needed to meet with some lawyers to figure out the structure of Create just because we're launching crypto products, and right now it's like a little treacherous with legal restrictions. So I met with a few lawyers and we figured out a way to create a social token in the right way. So we're planning not to do like a public token sale with our creators. We're planning to look into something called a non-transferable token because we're not trying to get into security issues. So that's the first update, and it's been amazing because I was stressing so much about it, but I think we have a grasp about that. Second, at Create, we are launching a social token with our creator, Nutshell. He's basically the project where we're really focusing on just because there's so much going on right now. But we're launching his social token and we're restructuring his entire community. So this actually goes into the topic of this video because when we were looking at his community, we realized launching a social token to his audience of like 10 million followers was gonna be very difficult because blockchain and crypto is just so, like I said, there's a lot of friction. So we couldn't just launch, hey guys, I have a NFT. Like, it's not gonna work that way. So what we did is really examined the three steps that I mentioned for his community. The first thing we did is, what are the values of this community? So Nutshell loves to make art, creatively express himself, and play games and meet other people. So we really looked at his creator community and his gaming community. The second thing we did is make sure that he cared about his community. So he went on Discord to talk to his fans one-on-one, play games for free, no financial incentive, right? Just because he wants to show that he cares. The third thing we did is this new strategy where we're trying our best to make people feel like they belong by creating an identity around the brand. So it's called the Nut Nation because his account is called Nutshell. And what we did is we divided the community between artists and gamers because we knew that we needed to separate it because the way that people feel like they belong is different for each community, right? So for the artist community of his audience, they only care about maybe making art and getting noticed, whereas the gaming community more cares about playing games and meeting other people. So we kind of separated the communities by using Discord channels. So we locked certain channels and closed some so people only saw certain things based on what role you had. So by this way, we're really just trying to make people feel like they belong. So when a member says, I am in the Nut Nation, they can clearly say why they are there and how the community has helped them. So we are really just trying to slice and dice the communities. So when we launch our social token, we can be way more clear on the messaging. Instead of saying, hey guys, get the Nut Token, we can say, hey, get the Nut Token because if you want to become a better artist, this is going to help you gain access to Nutshell, right? Or for the gaming community, you can use this token to get digital skins on Minecraft. So I really think if you have a larger community to slice and dice it, because it's really important to get your messaging really fucking straight, or else it's gonna be so hard to market these complex products. All right, that's that. At X8 Media, I mean, not really much updates. We're just finishing our 8 whale clients I mentioned earlier. Really fucking busy, really, really exciting stuff, but that's the day in the life of Jade working on 2 fucking companies. All right, guys, Jarmination, bestie. I really do appreciate you watching this video. I hope this encourages you to make videos because you want to, for your community, not about views, not about this shit, because at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. And I really do believe we need to start measuring different levels of success. Everybody and their dog is obsessed with subscribers and views, but I want to know how many people are in your community. How many people would buy your product? How many people would, even if you're not posting, think about you and ask how your day is? Like, those are the metrics we really need to value in the creator economy. All right, peace. Love you guys. Shout out to the comment winner.
Shout out to the comment winner. Comment on this post to be featured in the next episode.
If you want to be the next comment winner, all you gotta do is comment below. I love you. Bye!